one thing, sexual thing, is not easy to speak it in front of parents and the children. And government make many efforts to broken silence. But in our conclusion, if I can eat it, you mentioned three things. One of them is a need. But I ask you, what you feel about to penalize or to implementation the system who makes break broken silence about it in Africa? Because I am African woman, African people. I don't know if you understand my presentation.
So your question is about how to sort of around the implementation of addressing the need. So I think a lot of the focus, especially around this topic, has been among academics and has sort of been in a more research and academic sphere. So I think when we're talking about the different needs, I guess like in our recommendations toward the end, you know, the need to, you know, integrate this more or maybe have it be part of what government is working on, I think that's sort of a broad recommendation that I think applies sort of universally. More specific to like the African context, I can refer you, you know, for the type of work that is going on to address those needs, and I can, this is slow, I can refer you back to Marnie Sommer, who has, she lived in Tennessee.